that dial. Stay tuned for the most incredible event in pre-war history. Now, for the second time ever, here from eternity, off the wall and through the looking glass, Zippily Buddha, brought to you by the magic of television, made possible by a grant from God, produced by the makers of Human Beings, Mary's Little Lamb, Cotton's Petertail, Zippily Buddha, Norman O'Brown, this is your wife.
Da 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 da. Zippily Buddha, zippily a, my oh my, what a wonderful day! Plenty of sunshine heading my way. Zippily Buddha, zippily a, Mr. Blackboard's on my shoulder. It's a truth, it's actual, everything is satisfactual. Zippily Buddha, zippily a, wonderful feeling, wonderful day. Da 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 da.
This is a hymn to him, a procession, a fabric woven into the light of human memory in 1976 when transparent teacher's ink astral projected the word made flesh into Dr. Norman O'Brown's classroom in classical Greek theater. Brown's famous address to the Phi Beta Kappa assembly at Columbia in 1960 was considered to be the most important oration to that assembly since Emerson's The American Scholar. Dr. Brown's speech, titled Apocalypse, the Place of Mystery in the Life of the Mind, entreated the contemporary American Academy to open its mind and heart to the intuitive, poetic, mystical, and visionary side of human nature. He invoked the spirits of Dionysus, the god of holy madness, and Christ, the enthusiast of miracles and revelation, to guide us out of the trap of life tethered by the rational intellect. His momentous speech at the threshold of the 60s was indeed prophetic of the social, spiritual, and aesthetic revolution of that decade's youth generation. Dr. Brown is probably best known for his books, Life Against Death, Love's Body, and Closing Time. But though he is an author of printed texts, he cautions us against bondage to books and literalism. He refers to Emerson's American Scholar, which said in 1837, "The books of an older period will not fit this. The sacredness which attaches to the act of creation, the act of thought, is transferred to the record. Instantly the book becomes noxious. The guide is a tyrant. I had better never see a book than to be warped by its attraction clean out of my own orbit. The one thing in the world of value is the active soul." Brown observes, "This bondage to books compels us not to see with our own eyes, compels us to see with the eyes of the dead, with dead eyes. There is a hex on us, the specters in books, the authority of the past, and to exorcise these ghosts is the great work of magical self-liberation. Then the eyes of the spirit would become one with the eyes of the body, and God would be in us, not outside. God in us, entheos, enthusiasm, this is the essence of the holy madness. To see with our own eyes is second sight." He also states, "How far this university is from that ideal is the measure of the defeat of our American dream." And O'Brown is also well known for his negative responsibility to the consequences of his words, which defines his position as leader of the chorus in life's drama. The hypocritical nature of the chorus, based on illusion, is to repudiate the actions of their vicar. The artist, hero, shaman, is created to perform the deeds which are forbidden to the community so that it may enjoy vicarious experience from a safe, aesthetic distance. Sipali Buddha is precedent of the imagination, a state of mind not yet recognized by the bureaucratic order. She is a herald, an expert sound maker. Thunder is broadcast from the universal electronic network into which her robe is sewn without a seam. He is a living sculpture, painting, poem of the electronic age, which embodies the spirit of the Dionysian Christ invoked by Brown. She is a book, the word made flesh, drawn through the eye of the needle, through transparent teacher's table of contents, and the random house converters to weave a hymn in the light of reality. He stands for the second coming in the instant all-at-onceness of television, the electronic mirror printing press. She illustrates what Brown is writing about, the letter killeth, but the spirit giveth life. Had Brown stayed in his own place long enough to see the symbolism of this work, a transformation could have occurred, a confirmation, a union, a baptism moving us from history to mystery. Since the fugitive Brown once again deserted the mental battlefield, Sipali Buddha sanctified the ground outside of the classroom where the body and spirit of Hermes, the messenger of the gods, was resurrected.
Only be a king when I stop being.
5 minutes of tape left.
Okay.
Get the gun out.
Follow it anywhere. Dig a pit hole. Dig a hole big enough for everyone to jump into it.
Okay.
Humaney.